My name is Brian Dobosh. I am 23 years old. I am a research associate, more commonly referred to as a lab tech, at the Weiss Lab for Synthetic Biology at MIT, and I make $47,000 a year. So for me, when I started researching what scholarships were available to me, I felt very small. I had no idea where to even start. Under the advice of the professor that I worked with at Northeastern my freshman year, she suggested starting at the NSF webpage, the National Science Foundation. And there they have hundreds of pages listing the grants that they provide or are also provided by other governmental institutions. And so I started with this massive webpage, just clicking on every single link, reading through it, and seeing if I was okay to apply for it. For all of those that were okay, I started writing essays and filling out all the questionnaires that I had to, surveys. Something that really helped was to remember that if I just write on my own, I'm not that strong of a writer, I'm probably not going to get the scholarship or grant. And so I had teachers and also friends help read through my essays and tell me what was good, what was bad, what they thought about it. And that was important for me to get the scholarships that I needed. Fortunately, due to the combination of scholarships and family support, I was able to graduate from college without having to take out any loans. But in addition to those two things, I also worked throughout college doing a variety of tests. As I've been mentioning, at least relevant to my science career, I've worked in three different labs during my time at Northeastern. I was a TA, a teaching assistant, to help people in the class. And I also tutored throughout undergrad, and I continue doing that now. And all of these were supplemental income that helped pay through college. Generally, when I create my budget, I will round my numbers and underestimate how much money I have and overestimate how much I'm spending. That way, at the end of creating my budget, I'm pleasantly surprised when I save a lot more than I calculate. But for this, I'll use the real numbers. And so my annual salary is $47,475.96. Before taxes and deductions, that comes out to $3,956.33. And then for taxes, there's about 18 to 20% taken out, so 732. And then for my 401k, I put in 1,340. The 401k has $18,000 per year that you can put in. And also, if your employer helps match some of your 401k contributions, that always helps. Some other benefits that I get from MIT are dental and health insurance, and they also pay for public transportation within Boston and Cambridge area, and there's also a small amount that they pay for gas if you need. Another nice perk of working in an academic environment is that there's always food available. There's clubs meeting, and their leftovers come to us as well. At the end of all of that, my take-home, or net income, is about $1,876 a month. My rent is $2,500, which if you split it between three people, is $833.33 a month. And my gas and electric comes out to about $60, depending upon the month. TV and internet is $50, and my phone bill is about $40. And for my student loans, thanks to scholarships and family support, as well as having a few jobs throughout undergrad, I have no loans. Food, I budget about $40 per week for groceries, so $160 a month. And then I also enjoy going rock climbing, and so that's about $75 a month. And then also, because I can't just make food all the time, I do go out and I budget about $200 a month for that. In the end, what I have left over is $418 and I guess about 61 cents. And then I also have a few extra side income because I still tutor, which can be anywhere from $150 to $1,300 a month, depending upon how much I tutor. An important thing is having an emergency fund, something where a place where you have money in case something that unexpected happened. You know, maybe you fall down and break your leg. Something where you can pay for an unexpected occurrence. And so for me, I have 3 months of savings saved up for that, but I have more in savings as well. And so when I was creating that emergency fund, it was probably closer to about 30 or 40% that I was putting into my savings account. So what prompted me to budget was, like I was saying, in the beginning, I ate a lot. I was a big, fat kid. And so I had seen that my big issue was eating out. So I made an effort to cook at home. And when I started cooking at home and buying my own groceries, I realized how much money I was saving. And so from that point, I started looking at what other ways could I save? What could I be doing better with my lifestyle choices? So I guess my first prompting to start saving money was trying to make myself look good. For my financial goals for the future, I really don't have too many. I guess one day I'd like to have a house and live comfortably like most people, but I also have some hobbies. One day I want to have a piano. I enjoyed playing that when I was younger, and when I went to college that didn't really continue. I'll have a piano one day and have a house, and that requires a lot of maintenance. And so I don't have anything too concrete besides that stuff. So a PhD is interesting, and it'll depend upon what you're studying, but for most STEM fields, you don't pay anything. They pay all your tuition, and they will also give you a yearly stipend in return for doing lab work. For grad school, I receive a stipend of $30,000, and that's a reduction from what I'm making now, but there's also cost of living, and so rent is about a 40% decrease. Which is a big amount. Then other things in the area are also cheaper. It doesn't cost as much to go to a concert. But something else that happens in Atlanta is that you also have to have a car. And so that's budgeted for, because now you have gas money, which you don't have when you take public transportation here in Boston. So there are lifestyle choices, but there are additional scholarships and grants for grad school as well that can help out with that.